Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through ZRP routing algorithm, guys, or protocol you can say. So basically this works on the concept of zones, guys. Okay guys, we'll be discussing about it in detail, so don't worry. Okay, yes, so ZRP is an hybrid protocol, guys. Okay, so it is a combination of a proactive and reactive approach, guys. We'll be discussing about them, don't worry. Okay, so first let us go through proactive. Okay, so proactive is nothing but proactive algorithm. So in advance information is collected. So proactive means if you or someone says he is a proactive kid, he is an overactive kid, in that way. So basically he is ready for everything. So that is the reason why he will collect the information ahead of things. Okay, so that might be a disadvantage or advantage, but it's okay, right? In advance the information is collected, routing is done immediately. So whenever a node, a request comes, so send this packet to F, I already know the path I'll send, in that way. So it already has the data, like how to send, where to send, which protocol to use, all those things, it is 100% clear about it. So routing is done fast, but routing may be staled, data collected before. So basically it is collecting the data before, right? So if unfortunately some link has been broken in between, so will it be updated? There is a very rare chance, right? So that is the reason why this routing algorithm is having this advantage. But collecting the data is a good thing, right? Yes. Similarly, the reactive routing protocol. So reactive is nothing but whenever there is some kind of request, it will start working. Okay, so on demand, route delay is available. So basically it need to know the path, right? So once it got the information, so that is the reason why it will take some time. So route less likely to be stale. Okay, so routing will not be a bit stale, like it's not old data, it will get the real time data, right? Yes. So using the best part of proactive and reactive approach, so basically getting the info and on demand, so combining them both, we will be forming our hybrid algorithms, guys, or hybrid protocols. Okay, so zone is based on the radius of hops, guys. I'll be discussing about this concept, don't worry, the hops and all those things, so don't worry about it, guys. Okay, yes, so here we will be using two terminology, that is nothing but intra zone and inter zone. Okay, so intra zone is nothing but proactive protocols are used, that is inside zones, and inter zones is nothing but from zone to zone. Then reactive protocols are used. So based on your requirement, you will be using one in one place and the other in one place. Okay, yes. So I wrote with explanation also. So anyway, I'll be just drawing the diagram again and explaining it, guys. So guys, please concentrate for around 2 minutes, 2 to 3 minutes, guys. That's it. The video will be done, right? Yes. F A B G E H I M J K L. Guys, understanding these kind of things from images or anything without having prior knowledge is really tough, guys. So that is the reason why you need to understand the concept behind it, because even I wrote some theory, but from the theory you will not get that much clear idea, guys. So that is the reason why I'm just drawing it and I'm showing you again, so that how exactly it is working you can understand, right? Yes. Okay, so just give me a second, the diagram is almost done. Okay, so this is our sender, guys. This guy is our sender, the A. Okay, similarly L is our destination, so I'll be writing S here and D here. Okay, and the radius, we are assuming it as a 2, the maximum radius. Okay, so let us start. Okay, so basically the sender radius, it is 0 here, guys. So whoever is at a distance of 1, okay, so whoever is at a distance of 1 will be called as a internal nodes, guys. So who is at distance 1? So this guy is at a distance 1 and this node is also at distance 1. So call them nodes, guys, not guys. Okay, yes. So this node B and node C are called as internal nodes. Okay, so as our radius is 2, whoever are at radius 2 are called as a peripheral nodes. So this is at radius 2. Okay, this is also at radius 2. This is also at radius 2. This is also at radius 2. Right, hence D, F, E, G are called as a peripheral nodes. So basically I have written it clearly here, internal nodes, peripheral nodes and node names. Okay, yes. So whom you want to send the data, guys? So you want from A, you want to send to L. So basically this particular zone, this radius 2 is nothing but our zone, guys. So whatever is inside that particular radius which we have given is the zone. So this is our first zone, you can say. Okay, just for example I'm giving zone numbers. Okay, yes. So from here you'll be understanding that whether L is inside your zone or not. Is it there? By observation only we can say no, it is not there. So you are searching at wrong place, right? Yes. So once A understood that, okay, so it is not in my radius, so let me ask some of my coordinates. So these coordinators are nothing but these guys who are far away from A, that are nothing but the peripheral nodes. So it will ask D, E,
sorry D, G, E and F to check in their radiuses. So I'll be observing with respect to G radius, guys. So in a G radius, is L is there, so basically again two hops, guys. So this will become the internal node, this will become the internal node, right? Yes. And these will become the peripheral nodes, right? Okay, similarly this will also become the peripheral node and this will also become the peripheral node. So now G will be checking in its radius, so its radius is in this way, right? Yes. So now it will check in its radius, is there L in my radius? But the truth is it is not there. So again it will say to its coordinators, so E, K, M, A, for them it will say check in your regions, it might be in your region only, so it will say in that way. And it will, and let us assume K got the chance, so now K will be checking in its radius, so these and J and L will become the internal nodes and M will become the peripheral node and G also will become the peripheral node. So now luckily L is in our, in K's radius, right? So now we got the location. So A knows, A sent the request to G, G sent the request to K and K will send the request to L. So this is the path we have found it dynamically, guys. So it is not static, but it is also dynamic. So it is both combination, guys. So that is the reason why this is called as a hybrid approach, guys. Got it? Yes. So let us go through the theory which I have written here. So in A's radius, L is not found. So basically this is the zone. If I wrote it here, it will be better. Zone, right? Yes. So assume G starts sending its peripheral device. So basically A in its zone, it is not there. So it will send the information to G. So please G, please search for L. So G will be saying that, okay, I'm here. Don't worry. It will say and it will search. But it will get K until K only. It will not get until A, until L. So it will say to K to search, please search. So K will start searching. So luckily K finds L. So the path is found and it will send the data. Right? Yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea about this zone based hybrid approach, right? Yes. So now we are done with all the four algorithms which we thought of completing. The four algorithms, I'm just saying the names, guys. DSDV is our first algorithm. Okay. So if you want the full form, distance sequence, distance vector, we discussed about that. And similarly, we also discussed about the dynamic one, dynamic source routing, DSR. And after that, we discussed about the ad hoc on demand distance vector routing protocol, and after that we discussed about the zone routing protocol, right? Yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea about all the four routing algorithms. So in the next lecture we'll be going through some introduction about VANETs, guys. So VANETs are not in our syllabus, but it's an interesting concept, you can say, guys. So basically in our syllabus they clearly gave the differences between the MANETs and VANETs, so that is the reason why I have added VANETs into our syllabus directly. Okay. Yes. So we'll be just going through a small video, guys. It will be around 2 minutes, that's it. So don't worry. Okay. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.